Hi, this is Christy from www.thewaldorfchannel.com and thedreamangels.com, and today we're going to make a math project. This is my favorite math project in the whole world, and what it is a board that we're going to create, and we're going to put nails in it, 10 nails, and I'm going to show you how we can teach the children to count by twos, which is the beginning of learning multiplication, using this board. And we're going to start with a piece of paper, and I show you how to start with a piece of paper just because you can practice this way so that you don't mess up your board on the wood. What you're going to do on the wood and on your paper is you're going to trace around a plate. This plate fits on the wood as well as the paper. You're going to trace around a plate to make a circle because this is going to be the base of our design. So I'm going to start here. I'm going to make a circle. And I'm going to make the same circle on the wood. But right now, I'm going to have you make the circle on paper so that you can practice getting the spaces right. I like to just eyesight the spaces. I'm not going to, you know, figure out the diameter of the circle and, you know, put everything in sectors. What I do is I put one line at the top and one line at the bottom. And then I'm going to have five divisions over here and five divisions over here, with this being one. So this is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now we're going to do it on the wood. Now you can use any piece of scrap wood. I just happened to grab this out of our woodworking drawer. And your circle needs to be slightly big so you can see the designs that we come up with in the end. So I'm using what would be a little snack plate or a plate that you would put a teacup on. That's about the size of plate I'm using. That's about the minimum size of circle that you're going to want this to be. You don't want it to be any smaller. I'm going to trace around this on the wood now, just like I did on the paper. And if you use pencil, you can erase it later if you don't want to see the lines you made. There. So now I have a circle on my piece of wood, and I'm going to do the same thing I did on the paper. I'm going to sight my 10 lines here, or my 10 dots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, well that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I start with this one being 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I have the place where I put my nails. And I could use my woodworking table for this as well, but it's nice to have a piece of wood under here. And then we're going to put the nail. And you're going to put a nail at each of these points intersecting the lines you made in the circle. And this is a very fun project for children to do. I haven't met a child yet that doesn't like hammering nails into things. Now, we have our circle with our 10 nails, and now comes the fun part. I'm going to choose, and when I give the children yarn to choose, I love to present them the yarn in all different colors in a beautiful basket, and it's just so fun then to choose what kind of yarn do we want to use today. And I think since this week, I'm actually filming this on Valentine's week, I think I will use a red yarn this week. And what I'm going to do is get out a length of yarn that I can use on this. And I'm not going to cut it off yet because I don't quite know how much I'll need. What you do is you start by tying the yarn to the top nail. And now I'm going to count by twos for this first design. I'm going to go 1, 2, 1, 2. One, two, one, two, one, two. And I just said 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. We'll do this in a different way, too. You see, if you count by twos, you get this design. Another way to do this, or after you do it this first way, you can do it another way. Now that I know about how much yarn I need, I'm going to cut off some. You can also do this. You can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This emphasizes for the child when they're counting by twos, every time they reach the two, they have to wrap the string around the nail, and so that emphasizes the skill when you're counting by two. So now we're going to see what happens when we count by threes. So in this, we can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. '19, '20, '21. And this is the design we get when we count by threes. So now we have two designs in one. So you see there's a lot of potential with this. You can use it with all sorts of numbers, all sorts of combinations of colors. And as the child is doing this, they're learning the basics of multiplication. So thank you for joining me, and goodbye.